With more than a billion active users, Facebook dominates the social media landscape. And with the high cost of traditional advertising and marketing, marketing on Facebook's extremely cheap platform is a no-brainer. And anyone can do it. However, to make a killer ad that drives profits, it takes skill. Today, I'm going to walk you through the process from start to end so you can start making your very own killer Facebook ads. Let's get started. This video assumes that A, you've set up a business account, B, you've set up an ad account, and C, you've been granted access to run Facebook ads on a Facebook page. Now, if you don't have all this, you can Google this after this video and find this information readily all over the internet. So there are several layers to a Facebook ad. First, there's the visual element, the image or video that goes with your ad. Then there's the written element, the status update or the description for an externally linked website that goes with your ad. Then there is also the deployment stage where you're going to decide what geographic area, how old are the people that you're going for, are they male, are they female, both, what are their tastes and preferences. And then there's the analytical part. You're going to go look at your ads and analyze the data that's coming in and see where you can improve. You'll need to craft a message, and to start, research your audience. Who do you want to target? What are their interests, their values, average age, where do they live? This will influence everything that you put into the ad from the image to the targeting. A great place to start is on Facebook Page Insights. Here you can see a breakdown of the age, gender, and area people live in that have already liked your page. If you're trying to branch out to a new audience, start using Google to learn more about the people you'd like to target. Now you have several types of ad options. It could be an illustration or one of Facebook's stock photos. However, in my experience, the best ads are of the actual product or someone using your service. Beautiful photography and video will attract more attention than generic images ever will. The most common way to capture a high quality image or video is with a DSLR camera. I use a Canon 80D with a Tamron zoom lens. However, something as simple as a high-end prosumer DSLR like a Canon T6i and a standard kit lens will do. Now without going into detail, you'll need to be conscious of lighting, and if you're shooting video, you'll also need to be conscious of audio. After capturing a great picture or video, take it a step further and edit it in an imaging program like Photoshop or Premiere Pro for video, and maybe an audio program like Adobe Audition. Tweak the image quality to make it look perfect. Maybe take out or add elements. It's important to note though that Facebook has a 20% text rule, meaning that any image that has more than 20% text will be penalized or maybe even not shown at all if there's too much text. Facebook has decided this is in the best interest of their users. Depending on the type of ad run, you'll need to crop an image to a specific pixel height and width. Video has its own set of rules. All of this can be found on Facebook's help page. Or you can do what I did and just do a basic Google search for Facebook ad dimensions. If you're using music, it needs to be royalty free. This means that the music is intended for commercial use. Otherwise, Facebook won't run your ad at all, or your video for that matter. For music, I use audioblocks.com. Generally, you'll want to keep your status updates and link descriptions short, but not too short. An appropriate length for a status update should be about 90 characters or less. Again, you can find Facebook's suggestions on their ad guide, and I stick to this rule about 75% of the time. Now, if you have a big ticket item, like a house, you may want to provide a great first sentence followed by plenty of information about the house. However, don't use any more information than needed. Generally, the higher the price, the longer the written status update should be, in my experience. Some great ways to encourage engagement and click-through rates are asking stimulating questions, using witty humor, and offering ways to solve your audience's pain points. Be careful not to target specific races or age groups in your ad. This goes against Facebook's policy and can get your ad pulled. It's better to describe the product itself. There's two ways to set an ad. You can advertise an existing post on your page, meaning that you'd make a status update or schedule a status update, and then make an ad based off of that, or you can make an ad that won't show up on your Facebook page. To do this, you'll need to go to Facebook's Ad Manager. Don't forget to log into businessfacebook.com to access this option. First, you'll need to select the account. From there, you can set an ad. Currently, the button is on the upper right-hand corner. From here, you'll need to choose the type of ad that you'd like to run. There's a lot to choose from, so be sure to read the description carefully. I typically work with a small business selling a product or service. Types of ads that I run are clicks to website, brand awareness, video views, and page likes. Now we'll need to define our audience, or put simply, who will see our ad. Typically, I'll go back and forth between the options to define an audience to maximize my ad's estimated reach. This can be found on the right-hand side of the page. but for simplicity's sake, we'll start up at the top and go down to the bottom. First, define your geographic areas. Where do these people live? You can get as specific as an exact latitude and longitude point, and as broad as whole countries. And you can choose more than one point. I'll just type in the city that I'd like to target and narrow the radius to 10 miles. From prior experience, I know that the age group to target for this ad is between 20 and 65 years, and both men and women. A wide range to choose from, but this city has a small population. Now you can get very specific with interests and demographics. Type in the search bar for interests, demographics, and behaviors of the people that you'd like to reach. Keep an eye on the estimated reach. Adding more groups doesn't always mean increasing views. If a group or interest brings your reach down, you can remove it. Or if it doesn't matter to you, ignore it altogether. Another option is to exclude people. For example, if you have a high ticket item, you may want to exclude people of a lower income bracket. It can be a great way to make sure that you don't waste costly views on people that you don't want to see your ad. Connections are inapplicable here, but feel free to explore these yourself. While Facebook recommends automatic placements, I never use this option and always edit my placements. You'll automatically share your ad in Instagram's feed, which is different from Facebook's, and people have different expectations. I've made my ads for Facebook based on the research I've done. No need to waste my money on Instagram. Sometimes removing the option to display an ad on the right-hand side can increase reach as well. And it's been debated whether people actually pay attention to this area in Facebook. Many people believe that users have blocked out the right-hand side and don't even see it anymore. Ultimately, the call is up to you. From here, you'll need to set a budget. Of course, the more money you spend, the higher the reach you'll have, and you can choose from a lifetime budget or a daily budget. The advantage of having a lifetime budget is that you'll get to choose the times your ads will be sent out. Have a restaurant? You can make sure to spend money on ads only from 8:30 a.m. to 10 p.m. when you're open for business. Now set your start and end date. There's an option to have an ongoing ad with no set end date as well. Unless you're made up of unlimited money or working for a large corporation, set an end date. Speaking from personal experience, you don't want to forget about an ad and be charged money that wasn't in the budget. We're dealing with a small company in an area with a small population. I'll set a small budget of $10 a day for 7 days. I create new ads every week to prevent ad fatigue. Next, you can optimize your ad placements. Typically, I leave this section alone, but there are special circumstances that could warrant changing these options. Take a look for yourself to see if they'll apply to you. Now, after all this, you can set a name for your ad set and click continue. So what type of ad will you run? If you're not using an existing post, you'll have a variety of options to choose from. Check out the specifications on the right-hand side and double-check that your ad is in compliance. You can upload a video or use one from your existing library. We already did our homework, so we'll just have to make the right choice. Scroll down to create the text that will go with your ad and see how it will be displayed on the right-hand side. You'll also have the option to place a URL for a redirect to a website if you're using an image. Be sure to review all the settings, and when you're ready, hit place order. Now hold on, you're not done yet. We'll need to track our ad to see how it's doing. Going through Ad Manager, you'll be able to see your campaigns. Select the one that you've deployed. You can see your reach, how much you've spent, your schedule, etc. Click on the audience set to learn even more. Once you've reached over 500 impressions, you'll be able to see your ad's relevance score. This is a score from 1 to 10, with 10 being the best, 1 being the worst, and it tracks the interaction between you and your audience. You'll also be able to see the demographics that are responding to your ad. If things are looking great, or you see a specific type of person responding to your ad, you can edit your targeting. If it's doing well, you have the option to create a similar ad, or if it's doing terrible, you can delete the ad set altogether. You're billed at the end of the month, or if it's your first ad, you'll be billed at $50, then at $500.
If you follow these steps, your ads will only get better and better. You'll increase engagement, have farther reach for less money, and most importantly, drive sales. Do you have your own tips for making great Facebook ads? Let me know in the comments. I love it when I learn something new. If you have questions, again, let me know in the comments or feel free to send me a private message. Thanks for watching. Now go make some awesome ads, increase engagement, drive sales, and remember to always be learning.